Okay, so recently Parkinson's disease has been linked to the toxic herbicide Paraquat. You may be saying to yourself, what is Paraquat? I have never heard of Paraquat. I know about Parkinson's disease, but what does Paraquat have to do with Parkinson's disease? Well, I'm Matt Powell. I'm a board-certified civil trial lawyer who represents people all across America who have suffered catastrophic diseases caused by dangerous products such as Paraquat. In this video, I will share with you what is Paraquat, why it's so dangerous, the link between Paraquat and Parkinson's disease and other brain conditions like Alzheimer's, when and where Paraquat has been used in America, what you need to know if you suspect someone has been exposed to Paraquat, what is wrong with the warning labels, what are the common brand names of Paraquat you might recognize, why there are lawsuits being filed against the makers of Paraquat, the fact that Paraquat has been banned in many countries and yet is still commonly and widely used in America. Let me start with this. I hope you have never heard of or ever need to know what Paraquat is and how Paraquat can cause Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's, and other types of brain damage. Let me share what you may not be aware of. Paraquat is a highly toxic herbicide used to kill all living plants. Paraquat is similar to the herbicide Agent Orange. Sadly, Paraquat has been banned in many countries, but is still actively being used in the United States. As you can easily see from this 2017 map created by the United States Geological Survey, it shows Paraquat has been widely used all across America. From farms to schools to neighborhoods, Paraquat will affect way too many people. Unfortunately, there are estimates suggesting as many as 150,000 people may be suffering from Parkinson's disease, and many others have chronic brain injuries such as Alzheimer's caused by Paraquat exposure. Some of the victims are farmers and agricultural workers who were directly exposed to Paraquat while mixing, transporting, or spraying Paraquat. Many other people have been exposed to Paraquat by overspray. These people are victims only because they live or work within just a few miles of a farm. So, what about the big warnings on the Paraquat containers? The problems with the warnings on Paraquat is they only talk about the dangers of drinking the poison. They fail to disclose the danger of being exposed to low doses over time and how it causes brain damage. And the families affected by overspray not even were warned about the dangers of Paraquat. If you worked on a farm, you may ask, how can I tell if I ever use Paraquat? What does it look like? What are the common brand names of Paraquat? Here are pictures of the containers or labels and the common brand names that many farmers and their families may recognize. Each of these products contain Paraquat. Gramoxone, Cyclone, CycloneStar, Firestorm, Helmquat, Parazone, Paraquat 3SL Tigris, Quick-Quat, Purgatory 3SL, Willowood Paraquat 3SL, Blanco, Bonedry, Devour, Parashot 3.0, Paraquat 4.2SL RedEagle, Paraquat Concentrate Solera. For decades, Paraquat, with any of its brand names, has been known to be deadly poisonous. It only takes 2.5 grams to kill a person. There are lots of warnings that say, do not drink this, but there are no warnings about inhaling Paraquat or low doses of exposure causing brain damage like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease. Let me share a little background on how this all got started. Then I will discuss the significant compensation that may be due to victims suffering from Paraquat exposure. This started when multinational chemical companies began making and selling Paraquat in the United States in 1962. Paraquat is used on farms to kill any and all plants. Paraquat is sprayed on fields after a harvest. Farmers spray Paraquat in order to kill every plant and weed in a field rather than to till or turn the soil over to prepare the field for planting of a new crop. Many farmers have been told it's faster, cheaper, and easier to spray paraquat than to till the soil. However, the users were not told about the dangers of low doses of paraquat causing Parkinson's disease. Because of the dangers associated with paraquat, it has been banned in Europe, Sweden, Denmark, Cambodia, and many other countries, including China. It is interesting to note that China purchased and today owns one of the largest paraquat manufacturing companies called Syngenta Group. So China continues to manufacture and sell paraquat to the US, and yet they have banned it in their own country. So here's what happened. In 2009, the American Journal of Epidemiology found the connection between paraquat and Parkinson's disease. Soon after this paper was published, the National Institute of Health announced that people exposed to paraquat are about 250% more likely to develop Parkinson's disease than others who've never been exposed to the chemical. And shortly after the NIH published their causation between paraquat and Parkinson's disease, the journal Neurology published their study finding that the exposure to paraquat caused a twofold increase in the risk of developing Parkinson's disease. There are recent papers indicating that paraquat increases the risk of Parkinson's disease by a factor of 6. In 2016, the United States Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, asked the manufacturers of paraquat to develop training programs for users of paraquat to help reduce the risk of paraquat exposure through training and education. Unfortunately, these restrictions fail to adequately protect people living around farms from paraquat overspray exposure. Also, the makers of paraquat failed to tell the users about the risk of low-dose exposure causing Parkinson's disease, even though the manufacturers knew how bad it was. So, now that we've talked about what has happened in the past, let me next share with you what you can do to help protect you and your family if any one of them has suffered paraquat exposure that has caused brain injuries. Now, we know paraquat is really nasty stuff. It's very dangerous and has been widely used in the United States. Since paraquat has been linked as a cause of Parkinson's disease in several products liability lawsuits, people are becoming informed and want to know more about who may bring a claim for these catastrophic diseases caused by paraquat. We are all aware of the devastating physical and mental effects that Parkinson's has on a person and their family. Most of us know Parkinson's disease is caused by brain and nerve damage, causing tremors, stiffness, and a loss of balance for which there is no cure. What surprises most people are the expensive medical costs needed to care for a Parkinson's patient. The cost of care can reach into the millions of dollars. Next, I'm going to run through the paraquat exposure checklist. This will tell us who may qualify to bring a claim if they have Parkinson's disease caused by paraquat. We want to know the following. First, when? When were they first exposed to paraquat? What is the approximate date or dates of exposure? This is important because if a person develops Parkinson's disease 2 or more years after their first exposure to paraquat, then there is a good chance we can prove the causal connection between paraquat and Parkinson's disease. Second is the method of exposure to paraquat. How was the person exposed to paraquat? Was their exposure to paraquat from direct personal use, such as mixing, spraying, transporting, loading these chemicals? Or was their exposure caused by coming into contact after paraquat was sprayed on fields or crops? In other words, did the person come into contact with paraquat because of overspray drifting from some nearby farms? Did the overspray get to them at their home, school, or work? And third, how much exposure did the person get? We need to know what was the total combined exposure to paraquat. Approximately how much paraquat did they come into contact with and how often? If we added up the separate days of exposure, and these days do not have to be in a row, for example, 5 days in 2016, 4 days in 2017, 8 days in 2018, 7 days in 2019. If the total days of paraquat exposure is more than 20 days, then more likely than not, we can prove that Parkinson's was caused by their exposure to paraquat. If a person was exposed to paraquat after it was applied to a field, did they live around the farm area for enough days to cause Parkinson's disease? For many farm workers, they probably have many more days exposure than just 20. So this is a simple checklist summary of the information we need to know. Diagnosis of Parkinson's. When was the diagnosis made by a doctor? The date of the first exposure to paraquat. The type of exposure, direct or indirectly. Total amount of days of paraquat exposure. It's that simple. I am sorry to say that if you or a loved one meets this criteria, then you need to learn your legal rights and you need to learn how to protect your rights. You need to know whether or not you have the right to recover significant compensation for the devastating effects of paraquat exposure. If you think you or someone you love has Parkinson's disease or Alzheimer's caused by paraquat, please call my office and ask to speak with us about the specific circumstances of their exposure to paraquat. I'm a board-certified civil trial lawyer, certified by the National Board of Trial Advocacy and by the Florida Bar. I am an attorney who helps people all around the United States learn and protect their rights if they are suffering from Parkinson's disease caused by paraquat. If we think we can help you, we will order the necessary records, attempt to verify that paraquat exposure is the cause of your Parkinson's, and we will work hard to hold the manufacturer accountable for the damages you have suffered. If you have questions or concerns, please don't wait. Call my office now at 813-222-2222. I will give you a free, confidential consultation to discuss your particular case. There are never any upfront costs, and if I think you have a case, I will represent you on a contingency fee basis. I'm only paid if and when I make a recovery for you. Call me now and let's get started.